Hello guys and welcome back to my channel Civil Construction and Tutor. And in the previous video of shape, I forgot to mention about the design of the foundation with a basement wall or any wall subjected directly on the foundation. So in this video I'll be covering that point. So before starting the video, let me make you clear about that this video will mainly, or the sole purpose of this video is to make you clear about how to apply line load on footing. So I have already uploaded a video, design of footing in SAP with AutoCAD detailing and site practice considering isolated, strap, combine and mat. So I have already discussed about how to define properties, define materials, define sections in this video. So I'll just directly go into how to apply the wall load or uniform load considering a line element. This is the footing that I'm going to design with consideration of the basement wall. So you can see in the AutoCAD 3D as well. So I'm going to design this slab and there is wall which will rest on this footing directly. Either it can be a concrete or it can be just a masonry wall depending upon the structural requirement. But what I'm trying to say is how to apply the load. So the concept remains same, that is we'll design the footing for the unfactored dead load and live load, and according to that we'll consider the size of the footing. So that is unfactored dead load, which is the weight of the structure itself. So I'm considering a wall at this point, that is between these two columns. Similarly, between these two columns, and obviously these two columns, and this will be a void, and there is no any column along this width because the column is resting on this footing. So I'm just going to design for these four columns, and the load has been extracted. I have already shown in the previous video how to take load from ETABS and provide that on the safe. So I'll just try to show you how to apply line load for the wall that is resting on the footing. So this is the safe model for the footing, and these are the column, and these are already provided with the load. So I'll just show you how to apply the line load. So for this we have to draw a beam element considering this as a none, that is null element, because there is no any beam, just we are trying to apply load with respect to that line. So from this, similarly the load is to be applied in this, over this, and finally in this direction. So now let us see how to apply the load. So firstly you have to define the load patterns, and I have defined it as wall considering this type as dead and self weight multiplier 0 because we are going to give it manually. So okay, and similarly check for the load combination, and with service it is already included with scale factor 1, and for strength it is 1.5. okay, now let us calculate the load. So the basic idea is similar to that of the wall load that we applied for the beam in the ETABS. So I hope you have already seen that video, and for which you can simply calculate the load as unit weight of the material, that is we are considering a masonry wall, so 19 into thickness of wall, so considering standard, that is 0.23 into height of the wall. So let us see from the AutoCAD. Either you can go from the elevation, or if you have 3D then it will be easy. So the wall will rest between these two, that is the footing slab and the beam. So if you have floor height then you have to exclude the thickness of the beam, but for now we can just directly do. So let us see the height. So 3.73 into 3.73, so it is 16.3. now let us apply the load. So if you see here, for this two, that is along this direction and along this direction, the height of the wall is same, that is between the beam and the slab, but for these two it is different. So I'll just apply the load for this and this for now, and then we'll apply the load for these two later on, and there won't be any wall between these two because as I said this will be a void. So let us select this two and go to assign. Here you have load data and you can see distributed load on lines. Go for wall, replace existing load. We are going to apply force, gravity. So as I said, we are just applying the dead load because we will design the footing for dead load and live load, and that is also for unfactored load. You can also do over here 0.23 into similarly for this, let us check the height. So here you can see the height is 4.87. So assign load data, distributed load, wall, replace, and we have 21.28. So if there is any opening, then you can go for the reduction as well. For example, if there are any windows, doors, then you have to reduce that load by certain percentage, for example 20, 30, depending upon the size of the opening. But for now, we are considered that there is no opening. So okay, so you can see the load has been applied, that is the line load, that is the load due to the basement wall. And we will not consider the lateral load, which is caused due to the earth pressure or any other force acting on the basement wall. For that, you can just transfer that load of the wall to the column, and the column will transfer to the footing. We'll just consider the dead weight of the basement wall. Similarly, I have applied the column load. You can see over here. So this is according to the analysis. So now let us run and check. Considering soil pressure as 150 mm. So it is 150.19, so which is slightly greater. So we have to increase the slab projection to consider this, or we can also increase the depth of the slab. So as it is a finite element method analysis, so the depth of the slab also influences the result. So we can consider that for the bearing pressure as well. So 148.83. So this is okay. That is less than 150 kilonewton per meter square. 0.16, so it is safe against punching. And similarly, you can check for the slab design. So we have maximum reinforcement as 639, and along layer A we have 533. So you can calculate the reinforcement as well. So I hope this video helped you, and the basic or the main motive of this video was to show you how to calculate and apply the line load in SAFE, considering the weight of the basement wall or any other structure that is supposed to rest on the footing.